preparation. So I think if you have any questions for him, we can ask him now. That way he doesn't have to stay for the rest of the conference. If you have any questions for Mr. Bennett.
Tom, I'm straight back here. I'd like Tom and also Oscar and maybe Triple G to address this question. Like Oscar was saying, you guys, you and Canelo put on an absolutely fantastic fight. Maybe a fight of the year candidate. Unfortunately, we're sitting in a press conference talking about a bad scorecard. What do you think about that as far as the way the public reacts? They see a great fight, everybody's excited, and then they hear that scorecard and they're disgusted. Bob, I talked to him. I'd like to hear from Oscar and Tom.
That's what I just asked
him. Okay, gotcha.
You heard me say it. 118, 110 is not, you know, people are scratching their heads. People are confused. What I mentioned was that I did see Canelo win 7-5. It was a close fight, yes it was. And I do have to admit, in front of Bob here, that 118, 110, and Bob is not the judge, but 118, 110, yes, it was a bit widespread. But what I am hearing, chatter and social media, I'm hearing, look, it was a close fight. It was a great fight, actually, because we haven't seen this type of action in such a long time. Did that answer your question?
I'd like to hear Tom's perspective on that. Just that instead of just only talking about the greatness of the fight, we're talking about scorecards that people disagree with severely.
No, you're right, Dan. It was a terrific fight. Both fighters need to get credit for fighting each other and putting on that type of performance. But, you know, if she had scored it, or that judge had scored it, that same score for Triple G, you know, it wouldn't have been that way either. So, scoring it that wide for Canelo, I think it takes away from a lot of the performance of the two fighters in the ring. And frankly, it's just not good for the sport of boxing. Luckily, the other two judges, it was close, could have gone either way, but I personally had it similar to the way HBO had it, and we had Gennady winning by a few rounds, but like I said before, he's a champion, and he'll be happy to defend his titles many more times. Did you want to also get Gennady's perspective?
I saw computing all total punches. I saw reaction, people reaction. You know, for this the judges, it's terrible. For me, it's terrible. Not just this is not great. This is very bad.
This is for Tom. What? Would you guys prefer to have a rematch in the Garden?
You know, that really depends. This was Gennady's first time up here in Las Vegas. I don't think it's the location so much as the judges. We think Kenny Bayless did a terrific job, fine job between two combatants that were throwing big punches, and I think Kenny broke them correctly at the right times. He didn't let either fighter hold, and he kept the action flowing, so we have to give him a lot of credit. Gennady's fought at Madison Square Garden six times. He always was very comfortable there, but you know, when we made this fight, when I was negotiating with Oscar, Gennady told me, it doesn't matter where the fight is, just give me the ring and get me Canelo, and he'll take the fight, so I'm sure it'll be the same attitude that he has for the rematch, and then we'll just have to check the judges a little bit closer, just depending on where the fight is.
Thank you, guys. Mike Montero again. I'm sorry, I'm going to be a broker, but I got this question from Mr. Bob. Same question. Sir, with all due respect, we've had several controversial stories here in Nevada in recent years. Rarely anything is done. Obviously, this was not a 10-round statute fight. This was a close fight. Neither fighter won more than 7 or 8 rounds. Is there going to be anything done about Judge Elliott? Will there be an investigation? Maybe you sit down with your watch to fight again, have it restored? What's the plan?
Well, first of all, I want to congratulate both fighters and both promoters. I think the fight was very competitive. Why don't you just be patient for a second? Ask me a question. I take full responsibility and accountability for my team, okay? Adelaide Byrd has had over 115 championship fights or elimination bouts. Unfortunately, tonight, she didn't do well. She was off the ball, you know? So
it's not the first one.
Well, I beg to differ with you. If you go ahead and look at her last 3 years for every fight that she's had, you'll find that she's very close to scoring every fight correctly. I have looked at her record over the last 3 years. I've got the records from Fight Facts. So if you've looked at her, then you tell me if I'm wrong.
I think there have been several fights in recent years that fans who are spending hundreds, sometimes thousands of dollars for these fights feel the scoring is not adequate. And in this situation where you had two judges score a close fight, which is what 22,000 people saw, millions of people at home, and one judge saw 10 rounds to 2, I think what we want, sir, and I'm not trying to be a pain in the butt, I'm just asking, what will be done about this, because it's not the first time. Is there a plan to work with some of these judges to find out what they're missing that millions of other people are seeing? Because neither fighter won more than 8 rounds to 2. That's all I'm asking, sir. This is 10 rounds to 2 is just a little too wide. A lot of people here are scared to say that I'm saying I might lose a press credential for the rematch for saying this, but I'm asking what millions of fans, I'm doing my job, because a lot of people want me to ask these questions that a lot of people here are scared to ask. I just want to know what will be done. Is there a plan?
Of course there's a plan. I will I'll go over the fight with Adelaide round by round. She'll have to articulate to me what she saw, how she saw it, why she scored each round the way she did, and then we'll continue to move forward from there. There's not one person sitting in this audience that, in whatever their profession is, haven't had a bad night. She was off her mark tonight. So we will take appropriate action. We'll go over the fight. We'll look at it round by round, like I said, and we'll continue to move forward. But by and large, I can tell you we train very hard here. We prepare for the fights. I do a lot of background before I make my recommendations to the chairman and the commissioners for the officials. And unfortunately, and I'm responsible for it, that, you know, Adam had a bad.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Not at all. My pleasure. I should be asking those questions.